Drive ignition.
This is Ektar's Reviews, from anime to figures and beyond. Hey, this is Ektar, and you're watching another episode of Ektar's Figure Reviews. And today, it's exclusive Figma time on Ektar's Figure Reviews, and we're going to review the Chouyusha Haruhi Figma figure, or Figma Haruhi Brave Version, from the SP box of the PlayStation 2 game, Suzumiya Haruhi no Tomadoi. Now, you're looking at the very first Figma figure that is actually ever produced. This one was actually made before the first official mass release Figma, that's Figma Yuki Nagato. It's really, really an interesting thing to go way, way, way back to the first ever Figma that has been produced after we've actually covered over 30 different Figma releases. So it's nice and it's pretty nostalgic, so we're actually going back to the past. Let's take a look at the box first. We have the PlayStation 2 game logo, PlayStation 2 logo. We have the SP-001. This is actually the limited edition box of the game Suzumiya Haruhi no Tomadoi. This is a limited edition to... I have no idea how many copies. I've actually tried to search for the number, but evidently there doesn't seem to be one. But it is a limited edition, and it was released on the 31st of January 2008. It's going to be pretty hard to come by nowadays. It's pretty hard to come by now, and I'm sure there's one or two floating on eBay for some ridiculous price. And then you forgot to mention the fact that the box, like the PS2 Fate Unlimited Codes box, it actually keeps in tradition with the whole exclusive PlayStation 2 limited edition box. And I think that's really nice, because the boxes really, really display well together. Without any further ado, let's open the box and take a look at the contents within. So here we have the exclusive Figma figure, but we'll leave that aside for now, because we're going to take a look at the game box. So this is the game box of the PlayStation 2 version, limited edition. I'm sure that the regular edition actually has a different box cover of the game Suzumiya Haruhi no Tomadoi. Now, the game is actually a visual novel style game, but you're actually in charge of creating a game to please Haruhi. That's the plot of the game. So you can actually create three different types of games. One of them is like an adventure Dragon Quest-esque game. One of them is a fighting Super Robot Wars type game. Another is a Princess Maker-esque game. The game is a visual novel, and since I can't understand Japanese, that pretty much rules the entire game out for me, unless I can get to the parts where you actually get to play the games that you've made. Really, really looks interesting, and of course the figure is actually based on the, I think, Dragon Quest-esque game. We have Haruhi, which she is obviously supposed to be a warrior. And speaking of warrior Haruhi, here is the Figma figure in the plastic packaging. Over here we have a background with concentric circles, nothing more. So just like Figma Saber Lily, with the limited edition packaging, we see that there are actually levels to the plastic packaging, and all the accessories, including the stand, are packaged in an exceedingly neat fashion. Now, this is what I really, really like about the Japanese packaging, in the sense that they have layers of plastic to hold the figure in place, and not like the twist ties that certain companies use. But we'll get into that at a later date. But for now, let's take a look at the Haruhi figure after I get it out of the box. And wow, for the first ever Figma figure, they actually decided to start off with a bang, because it is exceedingly detailed and very, very well crafted. And as you can see, there are actually a number of pieces of plastic to protect the pieces from rubbing together in the box. And I'm not going to remove that, because that's really going to take a lot of work. And because I'm going to display her in the box later on, putting it back will be an even tougher job. So we take a look at Haruhi, and I really love the design of this figure and the character itself, because Brave Haruhi is actually a character in one of the games, and she is supposed to be a warrior. In her warrior motif, we can see that it's really, really one of those kinds of, if I'm not mistaken, Victorian or perhaps medieval time clothing, and the clothing is actually based on her school uniform. You can actually see Haruhi's school uniform skirt below this outer armor piece, and the top We can see her armband over here. The details on this figure are absolutely splendid. You can see at the back, even the little string details are painted in. We can see that there are ribbons on the knees itself. And at the back, all the lines are actually really, really well detailed, well defined. And the figure overall is really, really impressive, and I especially love these ribbons, these two ribbons over here. We'll get into the articulation in a minute. Let's take a look at the accessories itself. So first off, from the plastic packaging is a saber, and this saber is really, really nicely detailed. Just look at the colors, red, gold, black, and unfortunately in the plastic packaging, it's been inside for so long that it's actually warped slightly, but just a little pressure and hot water, we'll get that straight again. Very, very nicely detailed. Beautiful, beautiful accessory. If you want to get Haruhi to hold the saber, what you need to do is actually pull out the handle and slide the handle from the bottom of the hand and reconnect the saber. Otherwise, it will be impossible to get the saber into Haruhi's hand. And do not be afraid, because this is actually meant to pop out. What's more, we see that she comes with four pairs of extra hands, open, grasping, pointing, so on and so forth. Last but not least, she comes with the traditional Figma base and the three-pointed Figma stand. She also comes with an extra face, and this face is one that has her smirking and looking off to the side. Bringing back the figure, let's take a look at the articulation of the Figma figure. And it's the same articulation that we have all come to know and love. Head is on a Figma joint and it's fully posable, can rotate 360 degrees. The arms are also fully posable, up, down, in and out. It can rotate at below the shoulder, and it also is a Figma joint at the elbow itself. You can rotate there as well, but I'm not going to do that here. Hands, you can move forwards and backwards and rotate at the wrist. Waist joint. Now, for the waist joint of the Figma figures, there are actually two waist joints. One at the waist itself and one below the waist. This figure also possesses a chest joint. Now, we can see that just below the chest, we can actually move the figure, the upper part of a torso, up, down, left and right. And I do believe it's on a ball joint. So there's actually three joints in the body, two waist joints and one chest joint. I do believe that the chest joint is actually only featured on this figure. It's exceedingly awesome, especially if you want to get the Figma figure in a number of dynamic poses. You can move the legs, can move forwards and backwards, in and out. And as for the knees, forwards and backwards. And it can turn side to side. And of course, the leg itself can turn from side to side, just like the Revoltech figures. And the feet, we have forwards and backwards, and it can turn left and right this way as well. And for this Figma figure in particular, we can see that the styling of the boot actually, or the leg guard, actually prevents the feet from moving left and right. But that's nothing much to worry about, because the figure itself is so awesome, you're likely to forget all about it. And this skirt piece is actually a separate piece, and I believe you can remove that if you want to, but I'm not going to. And at the back, we see the ribbons here. The skirt is made of semi-soft PVC. The ribbon is made of soft PVC. And there is it actually, yes it is. It is on a ball joint and can be posed freely as well. Now, how amazing is that? You can actually pose the ribbons on her back to match any dynamic pose you choose. Really great figure, really, really great figure. So all in all, I can say that this figure is definitely worth it, although, I got it because I'm a huge Haruhi fan and I just want to complete the collection of the special edition Figmas. It is a milestone in figure making history. This is the first ever Figma figure ever produced, and it leads off to all the glorious, wonderful Figmas you see in production today. It's a fantastic figure. It's really expensive. I do believe it's really hard to come by right now. I'm sure that there are some on eBay for ridiculous prices. But all in all, this is a great figure, and if you actually play the game, this figure will be even more meaningful to you, because you actually get to play as Brave Haruhi in one of the mini-games in the actual PS2 visual novel game itself. Great figure, highly recommended for die-hard collectors and regular collectors if you have the cash. This is Zaktar saying, see you guys in the next episode. For the game Suzumiya Haruhi no Tomadoi, actually comes with a bonus disc that's compatible with the PS2 that actually features bonus content, and some of that includes CG art from the game, from the pre-production of the game, and a special 3D Hare Hare Yukai dance.